Letter 1. Premarital sex. On premarital sex, there is a popular saying that goes, "The sins of the fathers live after them." Adults have to be very careful when making decisions. It is always good to pause before making decisions and try to imagine the effects the decision could have some years later. When God establishes boundaries for our relationships, it is not because He wants to spoil our fun but because He loves us. God in His wisdom has preserved sex within the marriage institution because nothing good can ever come out of sex before marriage. When any man asks for premarital sex, it shows that he is selfish and covetous. There are no illegitimate children in the world, only irresponsible parents. Leave sex till after marriage. The choice of the person we pick to spend the rest of our lives with will, undoubtedly, go a long way in determining our future, happiness or sorrow. The time we spend courting each other is an all-important period, as it provides the opportunity for us to know the person we are planning to marry before marital vows are exchanged. The process of getting to know is one that we cannot but ask God for His divine guidance and direction. He is the only one who can reveal who another person is to us, so we cannot but be prayerful about it if we desire to be successful in our choice. Furthermore, we need to make sure this process is not thwarted by premarital sex. God abhors any sexual relationship between a man and a woman who are not legally married. It causes us to be bonded to another person before we get married to them. This sexual bonding is counterproductive as it has no commitment and in most cases leads to heartbreak. There is nothing that halts the process of really knowing each other like premarital sex. It does not only expose one to venereal diseases, but could also lead to unwanted pregnancy. One of the major ways God attests to our choice of a life partner is through parental approval. This does not in any way suggest that they make the choice for us, but that they approve of the choice we make. When this is absent, we may need to have a rethink on the path we have chosen to walk. Our parents and family members are our last resort when things are rough in life, thus, it is wise that we do not let our choice of a life partner cause a rift between us and them. God designed us to relate with Him in every issue of life, and until we have Him in our hearts, we remain incapable of experiencing true love. If you are yet to have a relationship with Him, I advise that you do so today by asking Jesus Christ to come into your life, to be your personal Lord and Savior. Sex outside marriage life is a thorough lesson teacher and some of its lessons are not sweet. When we fail to learn from instruction, the only alternative is the bitter pill of experience that awaits us. God's desire for all to live happily and joyfully through life is only possible if we heed His instructions. There are many people today who feel that the admonition on moral chastity is not only old-fashioned, but also quite restrictive. There is nothing more misleading than this school of thought. God is the author of life and the creator of every living thing. He alone knows enough about life to help through its stages and He frankly forbids any sexual relationship between a man and a woman outside of marriage. But God protects us by the authorities that He has placed above us. Little wonder He said in His word, "Honor your father and your mother, then you will live a long life." Exodus 20:12. The use of condoms is considered as a guarantee against pregnancy and sexually transmitted diseases. Thus many do not see the reason why they should not sleep with the person they are going out with, if all the dangers are insured. Firstly, it has been scientifically proven that the protection condoms provides is not 100% certain, as they could break during intercourse. This shows the folly in relying on it for protection. But beyond this is the fact that, Any sexual relationship outside of marriage brings us against the plan of God for our lives, as it severs our link with Him. I. Cor 6:9-10. Do you not know that the unrighteous will not inherit the kingdom of God? Do not be deceived. Neither fornicator will inherit the kingdom of God. Those who intend to enjoy life as God designed it cannot do so without paying attention to the words of God. Furthermore, the bond that is brought about when two people sleep together does not end when the intercourse ends. The people involved are not the same as they were before the act. Apart from the risk of contracting sexually transmitted diseases, sex outside of marriage prevents people that intend to marry from developing real intimacy. It blinds them from the issues that they should be tackling, and all their focus becomes the pleasure that they derive from sleeping with one another. Even when two people have mutually agreed to get married, this does not give them the license to sleep together. The Bible says that marriage is honorable in all, and the bed undefiled. Sexual harassment. Sexual harassment in schools, offices and homes is an age-long problem, but unfortunately, victims of sexual harassment have been reluctant to come forward to disclose it because of the attitudes of people. The victims are either made to feel as though they encouraged the harassment, or they are advised to keep quiet to avoid being accused of trying to destroy the reputation of the person s harassing them. This experience is always painful to the ladies and men involved. Our society has to stop shielding the perpetrators and begin protecting the victims. Every marriage has its challenges. Though the degree of betrayal disappointment differs from one relationship to the other, but the outcome of each challenge depends on the two parties involved. Marriage is two forgivers living together, and in cases where one spouse has been disloyal, the other spouse should be willing to forgive. The Bible says that we who have received mercy and forgiveness from God must be willing to show mercy and forgiveness to those that wrong us. It is not easy, but it is possible. Remember that love is not about the way you feel, but it is about the decision you made to live with, love and respect your spouse till death do you part. Good character and integrity are indispensable traits for every individual. The Bible says in Proverbs 22:1 that a good reputation should be chosen over great riches, for being held in high esteem is better than having silver or gold. Living a life that will bless humanity goes beyond good education, morals, going to church every Sunday, etc. It is about a life submitted, totally submitted to God. Everything in life boils down to our relationship with God. We were created to give Him pleasure, and the greatest love we can ever experience is found only in God. He loves you very much and is ready to soothe every hurt and straighten every crooked path, but you have to first accept Jesus Christ as your Lord and Savior. I want any lady who has ever experienced sexual harassment to know that there are men in our society who have integrity, character and are God-fearing. Their common denominator is that they are deeply committed to doing things God's way. As you follow God, He will give you friends, both male and female, who will care for you genuinely and will not seek to take advantage of you in any way. It is well.